Where did we last leave off? Well, our adventurers were tasked by their benefactor to recover the gray stone within the Crystal Labyrinth in Undermountain. Disguising as Umber Hulks, they got through the Githyanki sentries and into a portal that transported them into the Crystal Labyrinth, where they found themselves in a maze with invisible walls. After some careful traversing, they stumbled upon a gelatinous cube with a green key inside. They succeeded in getting the key before another party could, and now find themselves looking for the treasure room, where this ancient artifact is located at. Will our adventurers make it through the Crystal Labyrinth, locate the mysterious gray stone, or find their way up to the yawning portal for some R&R? Only time will tell. So, we can go to the map where you guys, the wonderfully drawn map that you guys have right here. And there's one drow left, and he is surrounded by all of you. Jack Daniels has turned invisible and taken off, and there's another drow dead on the ground, and slime is everywhere after you destroyed this gelatinous cube. What are you guys doing?
I'm gonna kill the drow.
So go ahead, Karnath. What are you doing?
I'm thinking Firebolt. With a +7, that comes to 26.
Okay, so 26 does hit, and damage, please?
15 fire damage.
Okay, so 15 fire damage. Can you please explain to me what it looked like?
Karnath is just standing there, like, at the edge of one of the little sort of cliff trap spaces.
Yep.
And he's just like in his hands, like he's holding them together, and there's this little ball of light, and then he pushes it forward almost like a Kamehameha type deal, and the firebolt just pushes right through the air and splashes the guy right in the chest, the drow.
And he takes a couple steps back as he hits him. He's looking around, his eyes are darting, and he wants to get out of there, so he turns around and he sees Og, and he's going to take two swings at you, Og.
And, that's fine.
Alright, so does a 20 hit?
Probably.
Alright, so 20 hits for 10 points of damage. And
half to 5, because I am raging? Oh, no, sorry, to 7. Because of necrotic damage. Got it.
Yeah. So it is now goes to you.
I didn't have the health there.
Og.
I'm just going to claws and bite.
Okay.
I believe you said it was a d20 plus 4 for the attacks.
Yes.
So those are all three of those there. 16, 18, and 9.
Okay. The 18 hits.
Alright, you said D6 plus 4, so I think that's 9.
Okay, and how do you want to do this?
Oh, you know, I'll just claw at his throat. You know, I'm a sea lion, I'm up in there, sort of flapping around. Maw's already bloodied, and I'll just sort of reach forward and just no more front of his throat for him.
Okay, and his blood just spurts out and onto the ground. He's dead. Okay. Now, everybody's out of initiative order. What are you guys doing here?
I guess I'm going to try and jump over this gap.
Okay, I need a DC 10, please. Dex.
Just a dexterity check. Is it
you can
like
give me acrobatics if you want. You can give me acrobatics.
All right. So with a +3, that comes to a grand total of 4.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So I get to roll. Does an 18 hit? Yeah, hold on.
Well, yes.
Okay, so 2d6 for me. Boom, boom, boom. And only 3 damage. So you lucked out. So
only 3. Okay.
So this thing opens up underneath you. The trap door disappears. The sea lion from underneath jumps through the trap. Just scrapes at your leg as you reach the other side. Okay.
Okay.
Anything else? You guys are out of initiative order, so...
Did I make it across or did I fall in?
Nope, you made it across.
Yay!
Well, I guess I'll just start, assuming there's no more counters around us nearby, so we're just looking left and right.
Yep.
Nothing nearby.
So what you see is the stuff that was in the gelatinous cube. There's, you know, some armor, some swords, coins. The key is Throb has in his hand. And he's hands it over to Og. He's like, here, hold on to this.
Oh, thank you. And sea lion talk.
He puts it in your mouth. Good lion. How long's your... How long does this last?
It lasts for 3 hours.
Okay, so it's an ability.
Something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, let me see exactly. 3 hours, yes.
Okay.
I'll sort of hold it in one paw and be like, in case you happen to teleport out of here and get replaced with some random creature, crazy to think about, I know. And then I'll just start sort of... would I unwild shape just to start carving up the bodies? That does feel like an Og thing. He would. He would unwild shape afterwards. Thank for key. Are you going to eat that?
He says no. He turns around. Well, meanwhile...
Don't wait to waste meat.
And while you're carving up the meat, meanwhile, on a nondescript floor of Undermountain, is an adventurer. So, Sajin, tell me about this character of yours.
The Lightfoot Halfling. He is red hair. He's got kind of tan skin. His name is Vannon Streetfellow.
And you were in an adventuring party in Undermountain. And
oh, and he's a rogue, by the way.
And yeah, and your party members did not make it very far and have passed away in horrible ways.
And unfortunately.
Yeah, unfortunately. And you are kind of wandering around lost, and you came across this treasure chest, and it struck your eye. And as you picked the lock and opened it up, a bright light flashed, and you found yourself where Throb was. Guys, this halfling appears and Throb is gone, and now this halfling's bending over. The chest is not there anymore, and he's standing in front of you.
He's just bending over in front of us.
Jeez, he's bending over like he was in picklocking a chest. He was like, and then it's gone, and he's just bending right where Throb was at. He's gone, and now this halfling bright light appeared, and there he is.
Did you take my gold?
More meat.
Who the bloody fuck are you?
Who are you?
You see a about 7 foot tall. You know how like an orca looks? Imagine that. Covered inside of tribal furs and such, holding a giant oar. and he's sort of carving up two drow bodies. I think that's all you would see from me if Kareth wants to describe himself as well.
Well, Karneth, he's like a 4.5 foot dwarf, gray dwarf, so he's got sort of dark purpley skin. He's got a big bushy beard, but it's kind of stained a bit in like I guess it's probably some sort of alcohol, probably really strong, so I'm guessing you could smell it. He's got dirty clothes on, and right now he's got a small little fire bolt in his hand that he's just holding while he's just staring at you.
Whoa, put that down. You didn't actually adventure.
I don't know who you are.
My name is Vannis Breedfellow. I just am looking for my friends. I think they're dead.
And what were you doing here, Vannis?
Oh, it's a long story. The the Duchess, she wanted us to come down here. She wanted this gem from Undermountain. It's a whole thing.
I'm going to activate my class feat, my aberrant mind telepathic speech.
Okay.
It's in the Avray chat in the Discord. Yep.
Okay, no problem.
I'm going to do it specifically to Og, and I'm going to say, what should we do with him?
Who is speaking into my mind?
He's saying that out loud.
Yes, he is.
And then,
who dares enter my castle? No, shit. My docks? My ship. My ship. My ship.
I am. I'm right.
There
here,
is someone inside of
me.
Fuck, I keep messing up the voice.
You'll get it.
Someone inside of my mind.
Don't worry, this is a one-shot. Character voices don't matter.
So,
now there are two short people. You there, small meatball.
Does not mean he's the same as me.
You are pale meatball, and there is lively meatball with daggers, it looks like.
Is that a whale?
I'm very uncomfortable about my size. You don't have to be rude about it.
No offense meant. I just meant like the animal, you know, like a whale.
I am an
orcane. You can become one.
I could, yes, if needed. This is neither here nor there. You are journeying through this mountain which is under.
Well, at this point, I just want to get out alive. So maybe if we stick together?
Agreed, and you seem to have replaced the scaled one. So maybe...
Well, I don't know who the scaled one is.
But I know you don't know who the scaled... You replaced him, that sort of a thing. It was like a sort of swapped places, and then your ass was showing. Neither here nor there. You can go ahead and take point. We are heading in, and I point in the north direction, that direction.
What exactly are you doing down here?
So, Dwarf, what exactly are we doing down here?
So let me explain what you actually see down here. What you see, is Vanis holding a torch?
He has two short swords at his hip and he's holding a torch right now.
Okay, as you look around, when you hold the torch to your left and right, a wall appears. It's sort of like ice crystals, but it's not ice. It's a crystal wall that you can see through. And once you take the torch away, it slowly dissipates to where it's not there anymore. So you can
Vanis,
go for it.
Vanis like tries to touch it.
You can touch the wall and it feels like
what
bricks.
What does it feel like?
Feels like bricks, like stone bricks. It's cool to the touch and kind of moist a little bit. And you smell seawater and like ocean. And when you look down, there's sea lions swimming around you in circles. And some are like scratching and clawing at the stone floors underneath you, but it's clear, so it actually looks like you're walking on water.
Okay, Vanis looks down at the ground and jumps. There's sharks in the water!
They are sea lions, to be precise. And what was your name, fleshier short one? I don't believe we've made introductions.
Vanis looks at the other fellow. Does he always talk like this?
Yes, he does.
That
well,
over there
Vanis
is
his name is Vanis. He said that like two times.
Did he?
Pay attention.
Anus.
Vanis Reed, fellow.
We need you to walk forward and take point, Anus.
Okay.
Vanis.
So,
Og knows he's just an asshole.
Yeah, he's just an asshole. So, if you walk one square up, there's a wall to your north, a wall to your west, and it opens to the east.
Right. free hand. Wall to west and north. It opens east, like and, so.
And south, of course.
Yeah. Go ahead, Venus, anus, whatever.
Okay.
I assume since you replaced Scaly One, you should still take point.
I'm going to just do a quick perception roll, see if I see any
traps
or anything dangerous on the floor.
Yep.
It's a 3.
Okay, everything looks pretty much in order here.
Okay. I'm going to just creep along, making sure, just seeing if there's any movement out in front of me.
Okay. If you go north, you're going to hit the wall, so you're going to take a step to your, you're going to move east one, right?
Mm-hmm.
You move east one, and now there's a wall to your south, a wall to your east, and it opens to the north.
Oh, wait. run that back. So,
okay.
You want east one.
Yep. Wall to your east, wall to your south, opens up to the north.
All right, so we've hit
a bend. So continue north then?
Yep. Okay, so you...
I can't delete the walls I've already made. It's cool. It's fine.
It's fine.
I'll work around it.
Like I said, I'm going to frame this and give it to you guys.
Thank you. That's
all right. So you're going to take a step one to the north?
Why am I not? Oh.
So what do I see down this hallway?
Okay, so you can only see about 20 feet in front of you and 20 feet behind you before your light kind of from your torch kind of fades out.
Do halflings have dark vision?
That's up to you. They might.
I don't think so.
It's pretty dark all around you in this area. There's not much to see other than the sea lion swimming around your feet and your companions and the walls to your left and right.
Okay.
So if you take,
I can't see. So 20 feet further down the hallway, still pretty much like
it's until you put fire or heat to it, the walls appear. So it just looks like a giant black.
Oh, okay.
Yep. It's like one big room.
So you don't see the. I get it now.
Yeah.
Also, each square is 10 feet. Just heads up.
Okay, so I'm half a square right now.
Yeah, and you can move forward one or back one, or I'm sorry, north one or south one.
Okay, I'll go ahead and move north one.
Okay, so you move up north one, and now the wall is to your east, wall to your north, and it opens to the west.
Okay. West one.
Okay, you move west one. There is a wall to your north and a wall to your south. And I need you to roll a perception check.
11.
Okay. It's hard for you to make out, but there's something to the west that is making a noise. It's hard.
What's he making out?
It's some type of noise.
What kind of noise?
Okay.
Yeah. It's... there's a noise.
Guys?
Yes.
I'm scared.
I believe in you, and I push him forward.
Okay. Vanis continues west one.
Okay. And you can test west one, a wall to your north and a wall to your south, and it opens to the east and west.
I think I fucked this up a little bit, but we're going to work with it.
You work with it. You're kind of supposed to be lost in this thing anyways.
It's more than kinda.
Okay, Vanis is going to continue west.
Okay, you continue west, and again, it wall to your north and south opens to the east and west.
To your north
keep
and
going.
South?
Wall to the north.
Wall to the north. Yep, got it.
Same. It's like you're in a hall. It looks like a hallway east and west here.
Okay.
You got this.
All right. There, it opens to the east and west, but the noise has grown a bit louder. And if someone other than Venice, gives me a perception, please, because he already rolled.
Do it.
All right.
God damn it. Okay, 12.
12. It seems like crunching noises.
Are you perhaps snacking on some granola or chips, fleshy dwarf?
I don't have any food.
Well, then there is most certainly a crunching noise somewhere nearby. I had hoped it was just you getting a bit peckish, as have I been. As I reach into the meat sack and just start eating some of the drow meat.
You're taking some of the slime that is on it off and flaking it off.
I have, what's it called? Purify food and drink just for this.
Okay, so are you going to keep moving to the west here?
I think I had it.
I will.
All right, so you can move to the west. One, two, hold on, and three. And then it opens up to the north, and the wall is to the south, and it opens up to the east and west.
Mm-hmm. So we're at a three-way intersection here. Do you guys want to go up or keep going west?
No,
I think there's a wall to the south. I think it keeps going to the west.
Yeah,
it
goes to the west.
Shit!
With those fins, it's hard to draw, man.
It's very hard. I would need to fix that. And we were following the left wall from the scaly one. So, I mean, it hasn't killed us so far, so might as well keep following left wall.
So you're going west one, right?
Yes.
All right. So now there is a wall to the west, opens to the north, and opens to the south.
I say we go south.
Yeah, we
can. I have a gut feeling.
Left area.
Okay.
So there's only some like real nasty one. Stuff down there.
There is a wall to the east and a wall to the west, and open north and open south.
Okay. Yeah, this is going to continue south.
Okay. Now, there's a wall to your west, but other than that, it's open. So there's open north, open east, open south, wall to the west.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess we'll go east.
Okay. As you go east one, you hear something walking towards you from the west.
I am going to...
But from the west? There's the wall to the west.
There's tons of, like, rooms, and there's stuff to the west that can go... It's not just one wall. It can...
Got it.
To the west area, and it is pretty heavy. Right. It's like, donk, 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 and it's coming closer and closer.
I'm gonna hide around the corner.
Okay, you can give me a stealth for me.
With my plus 10 stealth?
Damn.
That is a 17.
17. So you look like you're... So what are you doing with your torch here?
I extinguish the torch.
Okay, and you're...
And press my back up against the wall.
Okay.
I take my two short swords out.
Got it. What is Og doing here? You hear heavy footsteps coming.
I'll hold a frostbite at the ready if something appears. Okay, I don't have dark vision, so if I hear like some real like loud noise or something like that, beyond the obvious clanking, like sounds of battle, have it prepped.
Okay, and Karnath.
But I really want to be the dumbass and say, "Anus, where'd you go?"
What's Karnath doing?
Well, I suppose Karnath would have been following Vanis.
But he disappeared on you. He extinguished the flame, and then I know you can see dark vision, but he was too fast in a blur, and he kind of disappeared.
Okay,
he bravely fled.
Guess I'm going to activate my aberrant mind telepathic speech and just say, did you teleport on us again? Did you swap out with someone else? What's going
on? Can you reply to the aberrant mind, or is it just a one-way thing?
You can form a telepathic connection between your mind and the mind of another. It's a bonus action. Choose one creature you can see within 30 feet of you. You and the chosen creature can speak telepathically with each other while the two of you are within a number of miles of each other equal to your charisma modifier, which is 4. To understand each other, you must speak mentally in a language the other knows.
Okay, so we can... I can... mind speak back to you. There's something coming.
Okay, Carniv will then turn to Oggs and say, Vanna says there's something coming. Be prepared.
Oggs is gonna look left to right, because he's hearing voices in his head again.
he's speaking to you this time.
Oh, he's saying to... Okay. Yes. Okay, very important. Very important distinction. Glad you mentioned it to clarify that.
Okay, Carniv,
did you not hear the clanking? Yeah.
You, with your dark vision, you see a massive 10-foot skeletal minotaur start sniffing in the air and then locks eyes on you and is going to use his charge attack as he sees you. Here comes his charge attack, so...
I hope he bounces on the wall somewhere.
If the skeleton moves at least 10 feet straight forward to target, then hits with his gore attack. So he's going to move up. Boom, boom, right here. He's going to move up and...
he's right there.
Yep, he's right here. He's coming up here. Boom. And he is going to use his gore attack. All right, here is his gore attack. Does a 22 hit.
I've got 13 armor class.
Okay, so he, all of a sudden, out of the dark, with your dark vision, you see a blur of movement as this minotaur comes flying at you with his horns, hits you, and he gets two extra 2d8 more of the piercing damage here, so 2d8. So adding to this 13 piercing is 9 more, so 22 points of damage as this minotaur comes up and just slams into you. Alright. We can roll.
I'm not doing very good.
No, now we can roll for initiative here. So my minotaur has an initiative of a 12. So I have a 12.
And...
All right. So it is...
Vanus, 18.
I got a 10.
So Vanus is...
I got a 6.
But I was preparing the frostbite for
something. Yeah, go ahead and do it. You can do that right now since you're holding it.
All right. I think he would give a con save at advantage, probably, because I can't see him, right?
Yeah, so we'll do a con save with advantage. 1, 2.
All right, he fails. So he takes 10 points of cold damage, and he has disadvantage on his next attack roll.
Okay. That's pretty sweet.
Weapon attack roll, yeah. All right.
So it's going to be Vanus, you're up, and then it's going to be my guy, my minotaur, and then... It's going to be Og and then Carniv, right? I get that right.
I think so.
Yep, go ahead, Vanus. What do you got?
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and take a swipe at him with a short sword.
Okay.
Is there a way to roll with advantage on Beyond?
Just roll twice.
Yeah, right click. Roll twice. Yeah, but no, right click and it can say advantage, roll, disadvantage. Click the one you want.
That's for... Does it actually have that from D&D Beyond?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it does!
Nice.
The first is a 27.
Ah, freaking hits.
Okay.
Barely, right?
Okay. It hits for...
Oh, it got the assassin damage too. Holy shit.
Wait. Why did it roll a crit?
Well, it's your first hit against for them attack. I'm pretty sure that's how assassins work, right? Or I have to check the shit.
Yeah, let me look at the features. You have
advantage on attack rolls against any creature that hasn't taken a turn, and any hit you scored against a creature that is surprised is a critical hit.
So that should be crit, yeah.
Yeah, that's
crit. He's surprised. Sure, it's hidden.
Okay. Well, does he also get the 46 sneak attack bonus, too?
Yeah, he should. Sneak attack, you get the crit.
So it's 8d6.
But he did have a first turn. Because he had a surprise round with a charge.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he hit Karnan with his surprise round.
Oh shit! I should have hit him with the fucking frostbolt beforehand then. Said it was holding the deck.
Okay, the sneak attack is 20.
Okay, so.
And then the bonus attack, short sword.
So give me total.
With an offhand. Yeah. So, for the sneak attack.
Alright, tell me what your character did here.
Okay, so Thanis is, you know, pressed up against the wall. He's got his short swords out, and he's waiting for who was taking the was it Karnath or was it...
Yeah, Karnath took...
Who was the other one?
The blunt. The dwarf took the brunt of his attack here.
Yeah, he led...
You see it, eye level.
He led Karnath, his fellow shorty take the brunt of the damage, and when he had his back to him, he came up from behind and plunged both his short swords into the, well, I guess it's a skeletal minotaur.
Yeah, it's a skeleton minotaur.
Okay, so he's tried swiping the back of the skeletal minotaur with his short swords.
Yeah, and part of its femur just like cracks, and he turns around and looks at you.
Oh, you're gonna pay for this one, little one.
Alright, and he's like, breath is like steaming out of his skeletal face as he looks at you.
Nice, doggy.
And with that, it's his turn. So he's going to turn around, and he's going to take two great axe swings at you. One and two. Does, okay. Oh yeah.
So you did 26, was one?
Does 17 hit?
That's a critical hit.
He has disadvantage on those attacks, on that first attack.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's right. That's so true. This is the first. That's so true. So the 26 and the 17 is the first attack, okay? So
okay.
So the seventeen hits the critical attack.
Yeah.
So that's going to be 18 slashing damage, and then I'm going to do another disadvantage attack on this one. So 1, 2, and
it was just the first.
It's just the first one. It's 22. Oh. Yeah, sorry. It's only the first weapon attack roll. Doesn't matter.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter. So the second one hits too.
Doesn't matter either way.
So 19 slashing and 18 slashing. So that's what 37 hit points. So he turns around pissed.
Okay. And
cleaves into you.
I'm going to uncanny dodge. When an attacker that you can see hits you with an attack, you can use your reaction to half the attack's damage against you.
Okay, which one are you going to have?
Which was the bigger one?
You have an 18 and a 19, so the 19.
Okay, so I'll do the 19. What is that then?
So you're going to have...
He rounds down either way.
So you're going to have 28.
You're having 28 damage then.
Okay.
27, right?
27? Yeah, it rounds down.
Yeah, because you always run down. Yeah.
Well,
you ran down.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry.
Come on. You've rounded out of my fireballs enough times, you motherfucker.
So he turns around and just cleaves into you. Yes, you do have a potion of greater healing on you as well, so you can put that down when you get a chance. Okay, and now it is Og's turn. Go for it.
Does anyone have a light?
Hit him!
I can't fucking see this thing still.
You can see dark shapes. It's...
Do I burn important spell slots, or I just say fuck it and smack him in the nose?
I say burn your highest level spell slot.
Okay.
I guess I'll I'll step up front and I'll just shillelagh as a bonus action and attack him with my giant oar. Regular big old oar.
So what do you... So you're going to move up and hit him with your oar?
Yeah, 24 to hit.
24 hits, for sure. For how much?
Dealing 9 points of magical bludgeoning.
Okay. So he's turned around, focusing on this halfling that just dug into him and tore him up a good one with his sword shards. Oh, and you come right in his back and slam with your oar.
Random other question, just theoretically, would Alec potentially know that skeletons are weaker to bludgeoning, or is that...
Why don't you metagaming give me bullshit? It's metagaming, of course it is.
I know, but he was going to slap me either way, but...
Give me an intelligence check, and...
Intelligence check? Alright.
Yeah, give me an intelligence check here.
I got a 19.
Okay, now you got to give me a good explanation of why you would know this.
He's sailed around enough places. He's fought some necromancers before as a sailor. You know, skeletons are pretty common enemies for them to raise after he's killed some of the meat that's been laying on the ground.
Okay.
He smashes it into bones. Bones are weak and brittle, so he smashed bone.
Okay, there you go. Sounds good to me. You know.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, either way, it's still just the 9 points of magical bludgeoning damage.
Okay.
Which... if he was potentially weak to it, it would be doubled. I don't know if that happened, but you know, just theoretically, talking out of character.
Yeah. Let me see what we got.
It's up to you.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, how'd you know that? That's amazing. All right, so it's really hurt him. Its bones are rattling. Okay.
You make good paste.
Anything else?
That's all I can do. Absolutely, right. Bonus action there.
Karnath, you're up.
As Karnath isn't doing very good at all, he is going to cast a spell.
Okay.
He's just pointing his finger behind the skeleton about maybe 5 feet behind it, and he says, you fucked up, mate. And so behind him there's going to be this giant sort of frog toad person just appears, and it appears because I summon I casted summon aberrant spirit.
Okay.
Using my 4th level spell slot. So, this creature, I sent you the stat block.
Yeah, I see it. So it says, you call forth an aberrant spirit. It manifests in an unoccupied space that you can see within range. This corporeal form uses the aberrant spirit stat block. When you cast the spell, choose the beholderkin, slad, or star spawn. The creature resembles the aberration of that kind, which determines the certain traits in that stat block. Beautiful. All right, what are you doing?
Okay, so I believe that was my action to cast that.
That was.
So what I'm going to do is I have no bonus action cantrips, but what I do have, I believe, is something that is called a quicken spell.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to quicken spell. Let's see, which... probably... Yeah, Firebolt. I'm going to quicken spell Firebolt for 2... sorcery points.
Okay. There you go.
Hit him in the dick.
okay. I rolled a 23 to hit.
That hits.
Hit him in the dick.
He doesn't have one. He's a skeleton.
Okay, I hit him.
Hit him in the coccyx.
Okay. 10 fire damage right in the coccyx.
Okay, this... So you hit him in his lower half, just shatters in a bright ball of fire, and now he is half of his body's on the ground, the upper torso up is still up and going, and he is not doing well at all.
So you'd say he's prone right now?
He's not.
I was just going to say that.
He's not prone.
So we would have an advantage to hit on him? Just no, asking for a friend.
He's not prone. He is, okay. He's still upright, but he is lost his lower half.
I love when I do that in my games, and like everyone's always trying to cop an advantage.
Oh yeah, no kidding. Trust me.
Throw the flavor out there.
Hey, try these metagamers over here. Try.
What do you mean?
I've got forever DMs all up in my game, so like.
No.
And like, what? They're always trying. All right, it's all good though. All right, so what are you guys doing? It is Karnath. It's Vanus. You're up.
Actually, it is my aberrant spirit.
Ooh.
It does share my initiative, it takes its turn directly after me.
Okay, go for it.
Okay, so, it was a fourth level spell to cast, so it's going to make two attacks.
Ooh.
With its claws, which is going to be, let's see, melee weapon attack, my spell attack modifier, which is, sorry, this is, it's going to be a plus four. Okay, so plus four to hit. Oh, both of them are 13. Yep. Nat 13, so both of them are 17 to hit.
Yeah, both hits.
Okay. All right, so that is going to be 1d10 plus 3 plus the spell's level. So 1d10 plus 7. Okay, so I rolled two sevens for my d10s, so that's 28 damage slashing.
So do you want to make this lethal?
I think so, yeah. Karnath got hit pretty badly.
Okay.
Hit me lethal if it's already undead.
Well, you can...
Unlethal.
Yeah, you can... Yeah, I mean, sure, that's true. But could you knock an undead creature unconscious?
I honestly don't know
that answer either. That's a good question.
Well, the DM, just make it up.
Of course you can. Of course you can. Why not?
They're too boned.
Yeah. I mean, I guess you can hold it. So describe what happened with your slot here and how did it dispense of this minotaur?
Okay, so as Karnath fires that firebolt, destroying the lower half of this minotaur, the slot's just standing there behind it menacingly, and then its claws, both its left and its right, just come forward and rip and sort of tear at what's left of this minotaur's upper half as it sort of just rips it apart more or less.
Okay, and as it falls apart, it seems where the eyes are, two green gems clatter to the ground, and as this great axe clangs to the ground as well, it turns into gold pieces. All over.
Manus jumps on the gold as soon as he sees it.
You have any need for the gems or gold? I just need more meat. This bone do not concern me.
I don't need those gems or those gold pieces. Did you see what it came for?
I'll hold on to them. I'll keep them safe.
Alright, I need you to roll me a 1d100. And that's your gold that you found. And of course two green gems.
15.
That's what you got. It was a bunch of copper pieces.
God damn it.
It was
that's something that's my luck for fucking tens every time.
You let the dice speak. And they say none for you.
Roll 4d20 to be better off, but fuck.
Okay, so there's two green gems as well that you can pick up as well.
Using meta knowledge right now, but I'm gonna tell my slot to pick up the gems.
Okay.
That seems cautious enough for you. You were enslaved by mind flayers. That's too meta.
Yeah.
I mean, I just wanted to smack the skeleton, so I don't think it was too much of it. Just like, if I knew it was extra effective.
Okay. But so
either way, I think
would I be able to? Would I be able to look at these gems and see what they are, like what they do? I've got a. Oh, I don't even have proficiency in Arcana. Never mind.
Once you guys started settling down, you started hearing very weird noises all around you of creatures scurrying about.
It's just a short rest. Who's upset about a short rest? The long rests are scary, right?
Sure, stick around here for an hour and let me know.
Let's just get the fuck out of here.
All right, so where are you guys going?
Okay, so I guess there's a path to the east and to the south.
So, Gray Dwarf, how did you summon Toad Thing?
Oh, and how long did that slot stay?
I used my magic. What do you think? It only lasts for about an hour, but...
Is he friendly?
It should be able to deal a lot of... Well, it's friendly to me.
Vanis pokes the slot.
The slot just looks at you. And it's like eyes sort of like just it looks angry at you, but it doesn't do anything.
I'm gonna call him Steve.
Oh, sure, whatever. Call him whatever you want.
All right, tell Steve to go forward.
All right. So, which way are you going? And are you lighting your torch back up?
We should have the Kermit to the direction.
Does Steve have dark vision?
Let me check. I assume so.
Okay. Slots, right?
Slots are like underground,
right? Dark vision,
right?
60 foot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually,
so
slots are like from the astral plane, but doesn't matter.
Oh, are they? Pretty sweet. So they're like Gith Yankee. Alright.
Like
so,
enemies of Gith and all living things.
So we're gonna follow Steve, I guess.
So there is a wall to... Alright, from where the slot is, I'm looking at your sheet. Let me go back to mine. And... Okay. So where the slot is at right there, there's no wall to the east. There's no wall to the south. And there's no wall to the west, and there's no wall to the north. So you can go...
Jesus Christ.
So, yeah, east, west, or south, because we're already in the north.
Let's go west.
Okay.
I feel like you should go... Oh, that's east. Okay, cool.
Karnath, are you going... You're in control of your slot, so who's going? Are you going... Which way are you going?
Slot's gonna... Slot boy is gonna step... east
or west?
East, just because right. That's what Vanis said.
All right, so
it's the opposite of that.
All right, so he goes east, and now it is wide open. North, south, east, and west. There is no wall. You went east one.
Have him keep going east until he stops.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. Why not?
All right. Let me get back to mine. Alright, so he goes east one more. It's a wide open north, south, east, and west. He goes east one more, and now there is a wall to your east, but east. Open north, south, east, and north, south, and west. So wall to your east.
Go north real quick.
Sure, north, why not?
Alright, north, you have a wall to your north and open to the east and west.
All right, go south bunch. Wait, south, open to the west or east?
Yep, open to the east.
Okay.
All right, we go east.
All right, now there is a wall to your east and a wall to your north.
Going south.
Okay, now I got to read you something here. So number six.
Right.
Okay, so this seems to be the home of where that gelatinous cube was at. there is a mound of bones and items of all different sorts are in this room to your east. To the east, it seems to be just a pile of items.
Vanis wants to do a perception check for any...
Perception is kind of, for me, a perception is a glance over. If you want to dig through, it's an investigation.
Okay, he's gonna look around for any...
I want to investigate.
...gems. That is a beautiful six.
Okay, it's what you see is pretty rusted stuff, stuff that has been digested by this once gelatinous cube. Nothing of much value.
I just want to make sure I'm understanding this. It's like an end of a corridor where, like, we is like the positive items, or like it's a, like sort of like this 30-foot by 10-foot room.
It seems like a hallway that goes down into your east, but there's so much junk. This is where the gelatinous cube. You can see the slime all in the walls a little bit. So you got there's nothing much of value from what you saw. Other people can investigate, but you, from what you've been clinking around, it's just like crappy short sword, busted hilt.
A bunch of shit.
Yeah, a bunch of shit.
I got a natural one on the investigation there.
All right, no, you guys are really sucking at finding anything of any value in this pile.
I got a total of 12.
12, okay. You while they're all searching for some crappy stuff, you see a dagger with a ruby at the end. It's black ruby. It could be of some value.
There's only bones here. Only bones.
Karnath is going to pick up the dagger and just put it in his belt and not say anything.
Okay, you can give me a... what is it when you're trying
sleight of hand?
Yeah, sleight of hand. Thank you. That's what I was looking for.
Against anyone's perception? Okay.
Total of
it. You guys have passive perception?
Yeah, what's your passives?
18.
11.
18?
Yeah. Damn, Drew, man. All right, so you see him out of this corner of your eye. He puts some...
It's a shiny dagger and shiny stone.
No, you don't even see it's a dagger. Me. You see him just like... put an object away, you know, and tuck it away. You saw him like dig through, look at it, and then put something away, but you don't know what it is.
Og doesn't care.
Okay.
It's not an Og's character.
All right. What are you guys doing? Continuing on?
I think we're continuing. Yep.
Okay. Going
lead frogmen more down south.
You go south one, and there's a wall to your east and west, open north and south. Keep going. Same thing. One more east and west, north and south. Then one more east, west, north and south. One more east, west, north and south. Same thing. It's a hallway that's going down. And then one more. Now there's just a wall to your west. It opens to your east. It opens to your south. And of course, where you came from, the north.
I suppose that we're going to keep this trend of going left. So we're going to go east.
Okay. As you go east one, you see a barrel. Like a cask. And Og, with your perception, you hear a hammering sound to your southeast. Like ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch. Actually, you know what? Give me a perception roll. That's what I want.
I should have said that earlier.
Sorry.
16.
It's definitely a
hammer. If I had the previous roll,
it's definitely, you've been on ships before. It's a hammer on some type of wood and nails or something. Somebody's hammering something with... That's all you've heard the sound before.
Small people, someone is getting hammered.
Like drinking?
No, like hammers. What does getting hammered mean to you?
Drinking.
Oh.
That is a new expression for me. I will take it into note. No, there is sound of hammer on steel and wood.
Deep, what do your slot eyes see?
Give me, yeah. Roll your perception. Hello. For your slot.
Okay, I was just looking for that, which it should be,
Fitch?
Wisdom it's zero, straight, so right? It's just going to be a straight roll, so... Nat 20!
Ooh, okay. He sees a goblin is nailing a barrel, the lid of a barrel together. Over to your...
Okay.
Probably it is, with the nat 20, it is, from where you're at, it is down 3 squares over 4 squares. Kind of, yep. Down 3 squares over 4 squares.
I've been talking telepathically to the slide for a while now.
Yep.
Just telling him to move forward and so such. The slide only speaks deep speech, but it can understand the languages that I speak. And one of them just so happens to be deep speech. So he's going to tell me that telepathically.
Okay.
And I'm going to turn around to the group and tell them that. The slud sees a goblin nailing something to a barrel.
Like, nailed
it.
Like,
killing?
You first, small one.
Do you think I could pass as a goblin?
Well, you're ugly enough.
He said it.
I am going to take my disguise kit and try and make myself look like a goblin.
Okay. It's going to take you a little bit of time, but go ahead and roll. What is it for disguise kit? What is it? Deception? What is it?
Maybe just be a deception check, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead. Roll that. See how you look.
That one for a 9.
A 9?
Oh.
It's really hard to do in the dark. You guys, you see him, he thinks he's doing a great job of this, but it is looking like your 3-year-old did your goblin Halloween costume for you. And
I think this may be my best usual. Worst work yet.
Well, I'm really scared to see what your regular work is then.
This goblin is done and he's actually walking towards you.
You said there was a goblin to the south? Carnth? Carnth? Carnth.
Carnth and
Carnth?
Yes, I did.
Okay, Vanis hides behind Carnage.
Wonderful.
Alright.
I'm just gonna run forward and just hit him with my fucking oar.
Peace, peace, peace.
Maybe we can try diplomacy.
No. I'm just trying to fix these barrels. It's my job. I'm just working here. God, I hate this job.
If this was Tex, I would all be about talking to him. But this is Og. Og's his swinging.
No!
Og's!
No!
Alright, no, roll the attack.
Yeah, slot to get... Oh, okay, never mind.
I'm also bonus action, what's
he gets
it called?
To it. He gets to attack, go ahead.
With advantage?
No.
Just curious.
He sees you.
It probably won't matter. 20 to hit.
That hits.
Monster.
Oh god.
19 magical bludgeoning.
And you're making it lethal, I assume.
Oh yeah.
He just squishes this goblin. It's just a splat and blood just goes everywhere onto the walls. These invisible walls, and just like slowly falls to the ground.
I'll begin to butcher the goblin body.
Oh my god. You cruel fuck.
Yep. I got a 17 of survival there, so just, okay, that helps out at all.
Okay.
Just for like butchering, but you worked here. What does that matter?
Not nothing anymore.
He could have told us the way out.
Well, he can tell you with his body. Like, he's over here, he's over here, he's over here. He's resting in pieces. You know, it's not my best work, but
they can see that.
I'm glad you're on our side.
You best be.
At least some
lively meat.
So what are you guys doing now? He just totally just killed this goblin.
So, what do you think is inside these barrels?
I wouldn't know. Maybe we could have asked him.
You have a frog thing. It should work. Have it open a couple things.
Fine.
Have it.
Go
have
look
it
at the bottles, will ya?
Kermit barrels. It's frogs, Kermit. Oh, I'm sorry, I can't resist it.
You got it.
No one's finally understood. No one's reacted to it.
No, it was not your best.
Yeah, because we're not going to give you the satisfaction.
Thank you. Exactly. What are you doing? There's a bunch of barrels here.
I told my slad to break open the top of one of the barrels.
Okay. Breaks it open, looks inside, and there is a fish inside.
Ooh, dibs.
Just one fish.
Dibs.
He looks over your shoulder.
Why was a goblin putting a single fish into a barrel?
I don't care, dibs.
Wait, are there multiple barrels or just one barrel?
Just one barrel and there's a fish inside.
Like, is it like a goldfish or a salmon or...
It's a salmon. It's a salmon fish. It's a salmon fish.
Is it water in the barrel or is it just a fish?
No,
in the barrel?
It's just a fish.
Is it like a dead fish?
It is dead.
Right.
It's dead.
It's like a squirrel. Maybe he was storing it for later or something.
Ibs.
It would have rotted away.
You guys ever play?
Was this supposed to be like food for the sea lions? But
dibs.
Why is it only just one?
Dibs!
Yeah, we fucking heard ya. But this is...
Sure.
This is just perplexing.
Dog's gonna eat the fish.
There's a couple of more barrels.
Oh, please be more fish.
You know what? I actually really want to know now. Before I was just doing it because I was annoyed and pissed, but actually go and look and do it right now. I tell that to the slad.
Alright, he opens another barrel, and inside is two gold coins and a lockpick.
Eh.
Why the fuck is... What is this goblin doing? Where does he get this stuff?
You ever play...
Maybe these are his treasures.
You ever play an MMO? This goblin is supposed to go... He just goes around and puts random stuff in barrels.
And I smell any more fish.
Because these adventurers come around and just destroy barrels, so his job is just repair barrels and put random
items. Putting the loot back?
Yeah, and put the loot back in the barrels. That was his job, and you just killed him.
You missed out. The salmon is delicious.
How do you think these dungeons and MMOs get their barrels and stuff back after you break them open?
He probably had a family.
I'm just happy he got fish. In character, damn, that's hilarious. Oh, no, other way around.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
In universe, that must be extremely confusing. So Og's just gonna stand there with the two gold coins in his hand.
I don't care about the odd gold coins.
In the other, and just watching Og just eat that one salmon, and he's just...
Ooh, that's some good shit.
He's don't just worry. Standing there like, no wonder this place is made by the mad wizard.
Yeah.
Fucking...
Dude, the guy's a genius, so he just brings adventurers down in here so they die, so he keeps all of their gold and all of their stuff, and just more people come in there trying to get it, and he's a genius.
any more fish in the barrels?
Oh yeah, but you actually there on the goblin there is a bag to on his side.
Okay, Thanos is gonna paw through that.
Okay, do an investigation.
Okay.
Please, we have a good intelligence. What's none of our characters have ever had a good intelligence. Okay.
So as you dig yourself in there, your hand goes way deep into this bag. And you're searching around, you pull out, and it's a fish in your hand. And you bring out a fish.
Oops. Okay, he throws it at Og.
I will catch it.
Yep.
Then just bite its head off.
Okay.
You bring more good of those, boy. And I might keep you around.
Do I see this hand just go elbow deep into the small pouch?
Yeah, you did. All of you saw that.
Okay.
He's actually almost bending over. He's a halfling, so like his head practically goes down into this bag.
Do not disturb the fish pouch. I will stand in front of Carly.
you pull out something else. It's like a flower. It's like a purple flower. It's like it's
Thanos is just like throwing this over his head.
Yeah,
backwards.
Just random items are coming out there, like really bad, like really white itemed swords and shields are coming out.
Og's no longer interested. He's gonna start butchering the goblin.
Okay.
Alright. So who's gonna get this, what appears to be a bag of holding?
It's a bag of random common item of holding.
Oh, okay. That was a bag of random items for a second. That was...
No, not random. It's just very common items. Nothing... There's no rarity to these items. It's just very common
items. So is it like... endless common items?
No, what happens is that it's a room in the astral plane that the Mad Mage fills up with some just random items of uncommon value that he puts into this room, and a bunch of goblins around go and pick stuff out of this bag and put it in barrels. That's their job. There's help wanted now.
Then it sends the pouch to the slot.
So your toad now is in possession of this bag of common items.
It looks good on
him. As I summoned the bugger.
When he disappears, it just falls to the ground.
Yeah, but how long has it been since I summoned
him? You summoned him in that battle, and that would be probably about 15 minutes, probably 15, 20 minutes.
Okay. 45 minutes left.
All right, what are you guys doing here?
So we're just ransacking these barrels in the room right now. If there's any walls, let us know now so we can make an actual room here.
Okay, so where you're at, it is step to the right, and there's a wall to your north. I'm sorry. Step to the east, there's a wall to your north. Step to the east, there's a wall to your north. Step to the east, there's a wall to your north. Step to the south,
like
there's
so.
A wall to
so your... it connects to the other hallway?
No.
Best.
No, it's kind of like just before that hallway, and then there's like
south a wall to the west.
Yep, there's a wall right. All right.
All right. My frog is going to continue.
Are you in that hallway now? I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I think so. All
right. So you go down to the south. There is a wall to your east and a wall to your south, and it opens to the west. Seems like the end of the hallway.
Okay, gonna continue west.
Okay, if you go 1, 2, 3, 4 steps, there is a wall to your south on each of those, and a wall to your north.
Okay, so the slad has 3 directions he can go in.
Yeah, he can go north, south, or west. Or actually, he can't go south.
I'd say
because
there's
a wall to the south. So you can go...
Oh,
you can step one more. If you step one more, There's no wall to your north, no wall to your south, and there's a wall to your east. So kind of the hallway goes up and down now, or north and south.
I'm just going to make him go north.
Okay. So you can go one, two, you can go two spaces to the north, and there's a wall to your east and west.
North, I suppose.
All right. So if you go north, one, two, you hit a wall to your north, a wall to your east, and it opens to the west.
What the, like, what the first one, just to the west as well, right?
What's that?
Like, you said one, two, but for the one, was that
the wall? Oh, there's a wall to your, yeah, it stays, whenever I say you can go one, two, it just continues.
Okay, just making sure, just making sure.
Yeah, whenever I say you can go one, two, it just duplicates. It doesn't change. There we
go. West, in that case.
You can go west. One, it's pronounced two,
west.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. All right? Eight before it opens to the... It's that there's a wall to your north and south. Open east and west, but on the eighth one, it continues to open east and west. Its only wall is to the south, opens to the north. But I want to read you something here soon.
Great. All right.
While moving through the labyrinth, you have watched helplessly as a group of adventurers slowly lost a battle against a pair of enormous floating brains called Grell. As you approach, the final human falls to the ground after a blast of lightning from the Grell. Now, as you finally work your way through the maze to confront these creatures, one has wrapped up the robe mage and hovers back up the ceiling to feed. While its partner moves to paralyze the only moving figure, the armored man who just fell after the last attack. Both Grell are missing all but a few tentacles. Though the closest one still grips a small rod in one tentacle. None of the humans are moving, though you can't tell if they are unconscious, paralyzed, or dead at this time. All right, and that is, let me go to my map here. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 squares to your west and 2 squares to your south.
9 squares to west?
Two squares to the south. You see...
From where we currently are?
To where you currently are.
So, like, right over here?
Yep. And I think that's where we're gonna end it tonight.
Don't worry, it's coming. Don't worry. It's coming.
Jesus of a day.